Hello everyone, I am Raphael and I make art videos. And if you're returning here, welcome back. Today's video, I am going to be showing more of an academic drawing on something more existing, which is a horned-headed bird. Horned-headed bluebird. And I just thought about it, it'd be an interesting idea to experiment more with something more real. I'm gonna, right here, I'm actually just rough sketching it right now, and I'm kind of just starting off with the basic shapes, the curves. And I did use a reference photo for this. I actually used one of a certain wildlife magazine. You could always even look it up on Google and search for images if you ever want to use references. Always a good idea to use those. Right now, I'm just getting the contours in, the mouth and beak. And then later on in the video, you'll definitely see me more erasing things, adding things, figuring out. This is the rough, dirty part of the video. So, I mean, of the drawing process, because it's always messy at first. It's never perfect without it. Just figuring out the lines and the shapes, how the muscles go. Just figuring it out. See how here I kind of shave off some and then I added it. See how the actual bird is has sort of like a crooked looking neck. And what's interesting about it is that it's how it kind of, you think about how their necks move and everything. And over here I'm kind of figuring out, interesting about this bird, it actually has a horn on its head, or something flat and hard. It could have been used for, maybe for combat. Not sure, maybe it's for the crack. It's more nuts or something, but it's a very interesting bird. Give it a cutoff where I wanted to draw that. And here in the back of the muscle, I'm trying to add some muscle texture. I zoom it right in. And even though I am using a software program, this also reflects on even traditional mediums such as pencil or even a paintbrush. This still works. And here I'm just going over the refining the beak. Full, and you'll see it coming more to life. You guys are here, I'm adding more of the muscles inside now. Just trying to figure out exactly how the muscles connect and how to see. I gotta figure out why it's like that. Just imagine if this was real. You kind of make it very formable. The thing adding these types of shapes and detail helps it bring it more of a livable, a livable. So here I'm gonna fix up the crown more. So the shapes, makes it feel like it blends into the head more. Makes it feel like it's more of a connection rather than being apart. And then go into the beak, it connects it to the lion part. Fixing up the eye socket more. That way it matches up with the eyes. And if you are using digital, make sure you always I just did right there. So, just a little tip. Here I'm gonna fix it up with it. They here and it's just thing I am looking at a reference. So I'm always looking back at my reference to see what the neck really looks like, what the head and everything looks like. Just going back and refining. That's what this part is about. Now I got the drawing part and I notice it's a little bit off still. The beak though, over here I try to actually fix the beak. And you'll see this in a matter of moments, how I fix it. Get the beak was probably the trickiest part. You saw me fix it a few times. So it was straightened out. Right here. Got it up. This is how it kind of works a lot better. Now, since I got that straightened up, in a moment I'm actually going to be coloring this, however I won't be showing that too much. I just feel how it would look in the complete project of a lesson for the coloring part. Alright, so I'll speak right after that. Thank you. it for this video. About the coloring part, I didn't want to end up explaining it. I figured that wasn't so much important. I figured more than the real part of the lesson was just to draw the image rather than having it colored. And just this is just the last bit of it. So I hope you enjoyed it. I hope this is easier to understand. The drawing part, I figured that would be easier rather than the color. It would be a lot more specific and in-depth, so that's why I didn't want to explain that part. And I just wanted to make it just about the drawing and just have the finished product as the color part. So if you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up, comment, maybe even subscribe, please. And if so, then I will look forward to seeing you next time. Take care.